The Monaghan Stages Rally, round three of the Red Mills RAC National Rally Championship. The evening before the rally, the cars go through scrutiny. The atmosphere is relaxed. We see Mick McQuaid having a quiet word. Robert Moffat's escort with the Metro 6R4 engine is followed into scrutiny by the Subaru Impreza of Niall Maguire. Niall Maguire talks us through the extraordinary ending to the Kerry Stages Rally.
I couldn't believe it when I heard it. When we went for something to eat, we said we'd wait on the prize given, and then just about half past nine, quarter to ten that night, we got the news that they say that it was a tie, and we went away and checked our times, and all our times was right, but it's just that Gabriel Snow's made a mistake in 1 second. They just counted up wrong, and they made a mistake in counting on the fifth stage. They were second out, so it was advantage to them and a disadvantage to us.
The town of Monaghan is peaceful on Sunday morning, but up the road at the Hillgrove Hotel, the rally cars have already started to arrive at the Parc Fermé. The drivers are soaking up the sunshine, and Ray Breen enjoys a joke with his crew, while Daniel Doherty is anxious to be off. Gabriel Snowson is already following in his father's footsteps. We ask Gabriel about his battle with Niall Maguire at the Kerry Stages Rally.
Yeah, early on we put it up to him, but in the wet he came back at us and he took quite a bit of time out of us, and we really couldn't match him. The last stage were quicker by 1 second, and in the end it was a tiebreak and we won with being faster on the last stage.
Well, this is my local event here and I'd like to try to win it. So, and I'm going to try to go as hard as I can and as safe as I can.
Probably Niall is a bit of an advantage, it's home territory to him. Quite demanding stage, it's very slippy. Just have to go out and see what happens.
Oh, look, he's playing. Niall Maguire talks us through the first stage.
Well, the first stage is definitely a good, very aggressive stage. If you can hang in on that first stage and get a good time in that stage, I would say that would hold you for the rest of the day.
Here we see Niall's view of the stage from the cockpit of the Impreza. Gabriel Snow, driving hard, is now second and 6 seconds down on Niall Maguire, but crashes out on stage two. Robert Moffat holds fifth place and 12 seconds down on the leader. With Ray Breen, third place, 11 seconds down at the end of the stage. James Harrison is tied in third place with Ray Breen, but goes out on stage two. Mick McQuaid is losing time, struggling with transmission problems. And Daniel Doherty trying to make up time after a big off on the stage. Niall Maguire is hard on the pace, having pulled out a 6 second lead over the chasing pack. Here we get a good shot of Niall Maguire and Anthony Nestor on their way to the end of the stage. Robert Moffat's charge is about to come to a halt on stage two. Stage two is a difficult one, as we hear from Ray Breen.
Second stage, about halfway through, there was a fairly narrow road, very, very fast, with a lot of bumps in it. And the car got very, very giddy going down there. Just before you come up around by the farmyard, the car got very, very giddy. It was a big moment down there.
Eugene Donnelly battles it out with David Armstrong for third place. David Armstrong is starting to get to grips with the ex-James Cullen Ford Cosworth on his first drive in anger. Doherty is trying to make up time, but has an off on stage three, which had Murphy in the ditch trying to get by. In doing so, he damaged his power steering and drops out at the first service. Mick McQuaid is slowing. He's having a pretty miserable time as he heads towards first service. We caught up with Niall Maguire on the road just outside Auchnacloy.
We had a good old run on the first stage there. I think we took about 10 seconds to the next arrival offers on this first stage, but the first stage was very, very slippy, so it was, Rick. We had one near off and with a couple of slides on the first one, and then the second one we had a slide as well, and then we made a wrong tyre choice. So the third stage, yeah, we put on the harder compound tyre and everything seems to come together.
Second place man Ray Breen gave us his view.
The stages are very, very slippy out there. Second place after three stages, there's a long ways to go yet in the rally. There's a lot of people gone off the road, and it's very, very close to being on the limit and off the road.
By the end of stage four, Maguire leads Breen by 30 seconds. Breen is still down on Maguire, despite being 6 seconds quicker over stage four, but he still leads Donnelly by 7 seconds. In third place, Donnelly leads Armstrong by 9 seconds. Fourth place man is David Armstrong. And George Robinson is still running in eighth place. McGurk has joined the leaderboard in ninth position. Mac McKenna is having a terrific drive and has shot up to seventh place. Norman Armstrong, David's brother, is running in sixth place. Glenn Allen is still in 8th place, and the off-road specialist is showing his skill here. While Camillus Bradley has dropped down to 10th place overall. The Ballinode man, Niall Maguire, is driving really hard through stage 5 and 6. And the front left suspension strut has taken a bit of a battering over these bad bumps. On stage 6, Breen spins his World Rally car, ending up 2 minutes 29 seconds down on the leader Niall Maguire. Eugene Donnelly got held up by Breen's spin and dropped down to 4th place. David Armstrong has finally got the better of Donnelly and now leads him by 14 seconds. Despite leading Breen by 2 minutes and 30 seconds, Maguire is still driving at an unrelenting pace. Here we see just how fast the rally leader is racing around the Monaghan countryside. Try as he might, Breen is not making any impression at all on the rally leader. On stage 8, the lead is extended even further. It wasn't all plain sailing, as we now hear from Maguire.
We were winning, I think, by 1.5 to 2 minutes. And going into the 8th stage, we were going down a straight at about 100, 120 miles an hour and come to a junction. And I braked and I kept going on ahead and went down the road backwards for 50 yards. You know what I mean? And no competition, you know what I mean? Like, I shouldn't be doing what I was doing. Just lost concentration.
Ray Breen's charge came to an end with a blowout on the last stage.
Going into the last three stages, we were, I think, something like 16 seconds down on him. We clawed it back to the very last stage, till we were only 6 down on him going into the very last stage.
Breen's misfortune hands second place over to David Armstrong. Robinson has moved up a place to occupy 7th spot. McKenna has moved up to 5th spot in his air-conditioned Peugeot. Norman Armstrong moves up to take 4th spot. Enda Keenan from Tadavnet in the Squealing Pig is thrilled with his 10th place. Ulster man Glenn Allen scores a remarkable 3rd place. Robbie Hamilton takes 8th place. Sligo man Paul Parks has climbed onto the leaderboard to take 9th place. And here's some of the Monaghan members. Just see how Adrian McAvaney's car comes out at the other end of the sequence. Not quite so perfect now, is it? Niall Maguire's win was really popular in Monaghan, as you can see from the crowded ramp. Navigator Anthony Nestor is enjoying the post-rally crack, as a rally dog looks for the winner's biscuits.
I couldn't believe it. I'd say that's the first time in any of my career of rallying that I'd ever seen as many cars dropping out. But see, that's what it's all about, them stages there. They're so tough and tricky that one slide at all and you're off. Well, I'll give you an example there. Like, we were winning, I think, by a minute and a half to 2 minutes. And going into the eighth stage, we were going down a straight at about 100, 120 miles an hour and come to a junction. And I braked and I kept going on ahead and went down the road backwards for 50 yards. You know what I mean? And no competition, you know what I mean? Like, I shouldn't been doing what I was doing. Just lost concentration. Yeah, well, it was good for us anyhow. And anybody gets to the finish line, well, it's nice.
The result of the Red Mills RAAC National Rally Championship Monaghan stages. First, Niall Maguire and Anthony Nestor, David Armstrong and Herbie Blackburn, Glenn Allen and Adrian Johnson, Norman Armstrong and Kyle Johnson, Matt McKenna and John Loughran, and sixth, Eugene Donnelly and Paul McLaughlin. So Red Mills RAAC National Rally Championship standings are Niall Maguire on 40, Gabriel Snow on 34, Ray Breen on 32, David Armstrong on 31, and Dominic Loughran and Norman Armstrong both on 24.